Hello, America. I'm Kennedy, and this is Fox News Saturday Night. This presidential election is shaping up to be a clash of the titans in so many ways. The showcase of showdowns, the biggest grudge match in the history of presidential politics. And I'm going to melt some faces off with Megadeth's Dave Mustaine. Keep your booty in the seat. Stay with us. I love Miami. I'm a big fan.
I know this.
It is very much the Miami Miracle. I spent New Year's Eve there and had a great time. But if you're going to tackle the tough choices, you got to make it through this round of Would You Rather. You ready?
Ready.
All right, let's go. Number one, would you rather have Creed or Nickelback perform? Would you rather spoon Hillary Clinton for an entire night or wrestle a grizzly bear for 2 minutes? But not because of you. Would you rather bet in a street fight on Mike Pence or Asa Hutchinson? A year is Hunter Biden's roommate at a nudist colony.
Pass.
You can't pass. You may have had three past presidents who were mayor at one time, Andrew Johnson, Calvin Coolidge, and
Grover Cleveland.
Grover Cleveland. Are you ready for the job, or is this really to boost your national profile and name recognition for 20?
For us, what I've done as mayor and what the strategy and the vision that I have for this country, which is to create generational prosperity.
Embodiment of that. What would you do differently the Republicans are doing wrong on immigration? Have a beer with you or Ron DeSantis?
I think it's pretty obvious. Sorry, Ron.
What's your favorite beer? About you and from you. Thank you for taking the time.
Thanks a lot, Kennedy.
Always good to see you.
Great to be with you.
Stick around. We have a whole lot of show left coming up. Harry and Meghan exposed. Will the Tiger King become president? And I'll tell some knock-knock jokes in Times Square. First up on tonight's show. Brought to you by the eloquent sound of some sweet pundit poetry. Take a look. Joining me now to discuss, we've still got Miami mayor and 2024 presidential candidate Francis Suarez, outnumbered co-host and my friend, the lovely Emily Compagno, and comedian and libertarian legend and podcast host Dave Smith. He is here. Welcome, you two. Did you meet Francis? He's lovely. Yeah. Miami's such a great town. So, Dave, I will start with you. You host a podcast. How egregious is it to put your voice in later? Go ahead and enter it. They only did 12 episodes.
I mean, here's the thing that is always supported and that never has to be forgiven is hard work, right? You never have to apologize for that. That's the one thing, actually, that Meghan could have done that would have at least given her a rise from maybe one star to five stars, right?
Maybe if they survived a couple months of that, they would actually have an interesting podcast. And Harry could be like, they don't have any soft-boiled eggs. I don't know what I'm going to do. I love that Kelly Osbourne made fun of him and said, you dressed as an effing Nazi. You don't get to complain about your life. Well, there's another kind of king we all have to remember. Tiger King. Would make a better president, Tiger King or Joe Biden?
Joe Biden isn't really president. It's just the people around him. Mm-hmm. And I don't know that Tiger King would have terrible people around him. I think they'd be weird people. Mm-hmm. But I would roll the dice on Tiger King. Yeah. I swear, I genuinely mean that. If I had a choice between Joe Biden, he might not try to start a nuclear war with Russia, whereas Joe Biden seems to be trying to. So I'll roll the dice on that.
Yeah, but he's talking about like BLM reform, not Black Lives Matter, but Bureau of Land Management.
So confession time, everyone. I've actually never seen Tiger King. What? Not once. However, I love
him. Put it in our queue.
There was literally nothing else open.
We will.
There was nothing. There was the only thing in the world.
Kennedy and I are adding it to our Sunday night movie night. So instead of The Crown, we shall watch now The Tiger King. But here's what I love about him is that knowing really nothing about him, he came out with a beautiful, I thought, persuasive commentary on why we should vote for him. Coherent, which currently the commander in chief is not.
No,
Tiger King all the way.
I really like that. And I will say, in his defense, most politicians are gay murderers.
There you go.
Would you like to comment on that?
Isn't that right,
politician?
I said most.
I just can't imagine running against Biden's America, where the poor get poorer, America's weaker, and China's a lone superpower.
Is our panel committed well on the job? Dave.
Oh, I've never had a job. So if the punishment after you get caught is $70,000, that's kind of worth doing.
There's actually, I guess, a regulatory body that we can depend on, the good old DOL, to uncover these humorous stories.
Was $70,000 enough punishment for this boss?
Listen,
Hillary Clinton sitting on the other side, like,
wow.
All right.
Well, I'm not spooning her, so I know that.
Because I've married people.
Okay.
Do you think I should come to Fox and have people confess their sins to me?
I've married people too. I married Mark Anthony.
It's another one. Have them call me. How weird.
You told him I'm one and done.
Fantastic. Mayor Suarez, thank you so much for being here. Good luck
for
the race.
Me. Appreciate it.
Emily, always glorious to see you. Many more royal episodes await. Dave Smith, still waiting for your announcement. And I'll keep waiting. I may have two presidential contenders right here on the couch.
Lord have mercy.
I'm going undercover in just a bit on a secret mission to discover the truth behind the battle of the sexes. So which gender has an easier life? And we're getting all...
Dance like marionettes, swaying to the symphony.
Hey, you. How's your drunken Taco Bell? Love it. Well, the battle of the sexes is a tale as old as time. So, of course, I went undercover as my super manly alter ego, Rock and Roll Ruben. I break through in men's sports and find out which gender really has it easier. Watch.
Are you ready for this?
Uh-huh.
That looks very natural. Men's sports is about to be obliterated by Rock and Roll Ruben. Let's go. Hey, man.
How are you?
Is it running the best?
Not the best ever.
Are you worried that women are going to beat you?
Yes.
Oh, don't worry. I'm right here. I'm Ruben.
They're going to be stronger and stronger.
You're one of the best guys.
Thank you. For guys. Yes. High fives for guys. There it is. Rock and Roll Ruben has landed. Infiltrating men's sports. Let's do a little yoga. Aw, yeah. Up dog, up dog. As the guys do. Woo! Ugh. So much rock and roll, so many chicks. High fives for guys, high fives for guys. Right. That's right, high fives for guys, right there. Woo! A little bit of Ruben, a little bit of Rock and Roll Ruben. You trying? You trying? You trying to get me? You trying to get me? You can't get me. You can't get me. Holy Right here. That's what I came here for. Victory lap! I still can't believe I made that shot. That was real. Joining me tonight, a real rock... Oh, they've switched sides. Tonight, Jessica Tarlov, she will be arguing the conservative point of view. Many of you have been clamoring for this for some time. She's joined by Guy Benson. He will be arguing the liberal point of view. Can he own the libs with his new logic? I will decide who wins and writes for the VP. Are you both ready to play?
Yeah. I mean...
Guy's already glaring. Mm-hmm. It's going to be good. Mm-hmm. All right, Jessica, question number one. Why do you think Hunter Biden is the real crime boss behind the bribery scheme with his dad, and what punishment does he deserve?
Well, we'll start with the most important question, which is what punishment does he deserve? And all of us who are watching, I assume, are pro-death penalty, and it seems like that's the only option. The nation's law has treated us with such disrespect, and worst of all, is denying his daughter the life that she deserves.
Yeah.
And we'll all be sending her through college and making sure that she gets everything hopefully, that would be coming to her.
Hopefully not a liberal university, Jessica.
No, of course.
Sharp-minded businessman turned artist. Tell us why he's actually the smartest Biden family member.
Well, here we are. I thought we were finally rid of you, Kennedy. And now we're, I guess, in my parents' basement. This is what this looks like, Hunter Biden, to you, first of all.
It's doctor.
He worked hard. It's doctor. Okay, excuse me. The question is he a great American or the greatest American? Absolutely disgusting. Here's the reality. Here's the bottom line. Mm-hmm. Rethuglicans hate fun, especially this giant redwood of a birthing person here. They want to outlaw and weaponize and criminalize fun. And Hunter had a lot of fun, yeah. And they can't stand it. And they want to put him in jail for that.
Oh, yes.
And as someone who has pushed a little lady out of my hoo-ha, I can tell you that you are wrong in your views and that the Dobbs decision was the greatest gift to America I have ever seen.
Yeah, barf, Kevin Blah.
Front. Hillary Clinton, again, I'm not saying death penalty, but certainly in jail for a very, very long time with what she did.
Guy, do you believe Trump's handling of classified documents is the worst crime in the history of the United States or the world?
Both. Trump put us all at risk. And I'm going to now adopt your position. I am open-minded. This is a capital case.
Pains me to pick a winner here, but I have to say, Jessica wearing red and calling for the death penalty, you get to be Kamala Harris, the speechwriter.
All right. Well, we all win then.
we really do. You guys are heroes. And we've got much more on Fox News Saturday night. What is your favorite joke? We hit the streets of Times Square to find out. That's next. Welcome back to Fox News Saturday night. We are in New York City, the comedy capital of the world, and folks are looking for a laugh. So I went to find out just how funny New Yorkers and the tourists really are. Watch. Welcome to beautiful Times Square. As you know, I'm on the Laughs and Liberty tour with Jimmy Fallon, and reciting my three bean casserole recipe is putting audiences to sleep. So I thought I'd come here and exchange some jokes with the good tourists visiting New York City. Let's go.
Knock. Who's there?
The interrupting cow.
Interrupting.
No!
Oh, okay.
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
The interrupting cow.
Moo.
Ah, she knows it. She knows it. She already knew it. How do you make a waterbed bouncier?
A waterbed bouncier? I don't know.
Add spring water.
Oh, telling some silly jokes. The best in town.
The best in town. Ooh, yeah. A lot of people didn't know that I could solo like that. Jessica Tarlov and Guy Benson back in studio with me. What's your favorite joke or knock-knock joke? Could be the corniest joke in the world.
The quack one.
We don't have time for a joke.
Yeah, that one was worth the wait, though.
Yeah. I didn't do
Grandma
it.
Was hilarious.
Oh, thank you, Jessica.
Oh, I didn't even say it. Say it fast.
That's okay. You can't. We don't
it's
have
over.
Any time.
We're done.
It's all for the Saturday night. If you want more jokes, we got tickets on sale now for the Laughs and Liberty Tour coming to a city near you. And please set your DVR for 10 p.m. Eastern right here every Saturday night. Good night.